Hello everyone. Good afternoon to all of you. Welcome to the new session of our e-learning class. I am Rashmi Ranjan Mishra, lecturer of UN Autonomous College of Science and Technology. Today, I am going to discuss in front of you the subject regarding financial institutions and market. So on today's discussion, I will discuss regarding depository service. So what is that depository service? Who are the organizations or institutions that are providing depository service facilities? What is their role and objectives in the financial market at the time of providing that depository service? So listen carefully, watch my video. If you are having any doubt, then you can ask me in the comment section. So first, we must have to know what is depository system and when it was introduced. Depository system came into force with effect from September 20, 1995. So basically in financial market, depository service facility or depository system was introduced from the year 1995. So first we have to know what is scrip-based system, why the depository system was introduced. Before that, we must have to know scrip-based system, meaning matlab kya hua. So scrip-based system of securities transaction involves a number of paperwork involving certificate and transfer deeds. Simply, securities are held in physical form. So basically, scrip-based system implies a system where the financial securities are made in the form of a paperwork, or when any type of a financial transaction or security transaction that helps but that contains a number of paperwork and basically that involves certain transfer deeds, that is called as a scrip-based system. So in scrip-based systems, securities are held in a physical form. What is the basic feature of scrip-based system? The first one is there is physical movement of a security certificate along with a transfer deeds. So when securities are made or when the transactions are made in scrip-based system or in paperwork, that basically involves the physical movement of shares or share certificates or security certificates along with a transfer deed. A certificate that contains certain transfer deeds between the issuer and the investors, that made in physical form, and that basically movement of that certificate and the deed from issuer to the investors. And the second one is registration with the company. So in case of a scrip-based system, basically registration made with the company, those are going to issue their securities. So what is the problem arises in scrip-based system? When the scrip-based system was implemented in a financial market, there are certain demerits or there are certain problems. The first one is time-consuming process. Basically, when securities are made in a physical form or that contains paperwork, that takes more time and the processing time is become more, and that's why it is called as a time consuming process. That is one of the demerit point. Second one is bad delivery due to signature differences. So when paperwork is made or securities are held in a physical form, there is a chances of a bad delivery because of signature mismatch or signature difference. So more chances of a signature duplicate, and when signature duplicate arises, that basically involves bad delivery of a securities. Another demerit was mistake in completion of a transfer deeds. So in a physical system or scrip-based system, at the time of a transfer of a securities from issuer to the investor, one deed is made and maybe there is a chances of mistakes in completion of the transfer deeds. Then the next one is tearing and mutilation of a certificate. There is also a scope of a securities tearing or a securities mutilation. Another one is also chances of there is fake certificate. The company also generate a fake certificate against the issuer. And the cost is also more relating to stamp duty. When physical form of a securities or transaction is made, in that case, that basically involves a different cost. That cost may be stamp duty or other delivery charges or some other expenses, which the cost involvement is more, which is one of the demerit point. Then the last demerit is postal delay and charges. At the time of a securities held in physical form, the company will transfer that physical certificate with the transfer deeds to the investor through postal. So it will take more time, or there may be delay in postal delivery, as well as there also involve postal charges. So these are the some of the demerits that relate to scrip based system. In order to avoid that scrip based system, or in order to avoid the problem which arises in scrip based system, another system of a transaction of a financial securities is made, that is called as a depository system, where securities are not held in physical form, that is held in electronic form, and that depends upon the investor's acceptance. If the investor wishes to make their shares or securities instead of a physical form in electronic form, then that securities when held in electronic form, that is called as the depository system. So what is that depository system, and what are the features or the characteristics of a depository system? Now we will discuss that. A system in which securities of an investors are held by depository on behalf of and at the request of an investor in an electronic form. So in case of a depository system, securities are held, or the securities of an investor is held by depository, and that is on behalf of and at the request of an investor. On behalf of the investor and at the request of the investor. When investor request that my share will be held in a depository form, then the depository service organization will held the shares of that particular investor in a electronic form, and that is called as a depository system. So this depository system is also known as a scripless trading system. That means there is no work of a paper, or there is no paperwork. Instead of a paperwork, everything is made in electronic form, which is very easy from company point of view as well as from investor point of view. So what is the basic features or the characteristics of the depository system? In a depository system, securities are held in a depository account, which is more or less similar to holding funds in a bank account. So in depository system, basically investors' shares or securities are held in electronic form, and in that is the depository account of the investor, and that basically more or less similar to the deposit account, or the amount of funds when deposited by one person in a particular bank, and the bank will issue one type of a passbook to the particular customer. In that case, bank will keep all the information of that particular customer through a particular account number which is allotted by the bank, and everything is maintained in the particular bank account number through electronic form, or which is made through computer, and that is similar to the depository system. When one investor wants to buy the securities, their securities or shares are held in electronic form, and that is at the request of the investor, and that electronic form is made by the depository service organization. So the service facility provided by the depository service is more or less similar to the holding of a funds in a particular bank account by a customer. And the second features of the depository system is transfer of ownership of a securities is done through simple account transfer. So when one customer wants to transfer its account from one bank to another bank of the relating to same bank, but from one area to another area, what the transfer of bank account is made, that is very similar to the transfer of ownership of securities, and through simple process or through simple account transfer, everything can be made. Then the second third features that is relating to this method does away with all the risks and hassles normally associated with the paperwork. So what the risks or the procedures or the problems that normally arises in case of a script based system or in paperwork, that is not available in depository system. That means depository system keeps away with all the risks and hassles which normally arises in case of a paperwork. Then the next characteristics, consequently the cost of a transacting in a depository environment is considerably low as compared to transaction in a certificate. So The cost involvement in scrip-based system is more high relating to stamp duty, postal charges or other expenses. But in case of a depository service facilities or a depository system, everything is made electronically. So there is less cost involvement as compared to scrip-based system. So the transaction cost or the cost of a transacting in a depository environment is considerably lower as compared to transactions held in certificate forms. Then the next one is constituents of a depository system. Who are the participants or the constituents that involved in a depository system? Basically, there are four participants. One is the depository. Second one is the depository participants. Then the third one is the issuing company. And the fourth one is the investors. We will listen one by one. Who is the depository? Depository facilitates holding of securities in electronic form and enables security transaction to be processed by book entry by depository participants. And depository participants is an agent of the depository, offers depository service to the investors. So basically, depository means the depository organizations. Those are hold the securities in electronic form and they enables security transaction which has to be processed through book entry. And the second one, which is called as the depository participants, basically depository participants are the organization who act as an agent of the depository system or the depository services, and they provide services to the investor. That means depository participants are responsible to provide various depository services to the investors. And who can be a depository? Depository Act 1996 provides that depository means a company which is formed and registered under Companies Act 1956. So this is very important. Depository means one organization or one institution that is formed under the Companies Act and that is registered under the Companies Act 1956. And that depository organization also eligible to get a certificate of registration from SEBI. If one organization is not able to get the certificate from Securities and Exchange Board of India, that organization is not eligible to provide a depository service facility to the investors. So basically, depository are the organizations, they are first registered and operated through Companies Act 1956, and also they are eligible to get a certificate, and that certificate must have to be issued by Securities Exchange Board of India, SEBI. Who are the depository organizations in India? Depository model adopted in India provides a competitive multi-depository service. There can be various entities they are providing depository service, and such systems are known as multidisciplinary or multi-depository system. Various organizations are in India, they are providing different types of depository service facilities and they are called as the multi-depository systems. And at present in India, there are two prominent depository service organizations. One is called as Nsdl, second one is Cdsl. Nsdl, that stands for National Securities Depository Limited, and the second one is Cdsl, that stands for Central Depository Service India Limited. These two organizations are registered and operated under the Companies Act 1956, and they are also eligible to get the certificate from SEBI. So these are the two prominent stock depository service. They are providing service facilities or a depository system service facility to the investors. So now we are going to discuss what is NSDL, what are the basic service facilities that are provided by NSDL. National Securities Depository Limited, which is one of the recognized depository in India, which creates a competitive environment that will respond better user interest and demand. So it is one of the recognized depository service in India, controlled and operated to provide all type of depository service facilities, and that also eligible to create a competitive environment which responds to the user's interest as well as demand. NSDL is the first depository in India and it was established in the year 1996. It commenced its operation from 8th November 1996. Since then, it has been growing rapidly. From the year of operational activity, it continues its service activities in a steadily way or growing its activities steadily. So who are the promoters of NSDL? One is Industrial Development Bank of India Limited, second one is Unit Trust of India, the third one is National Stock Exchange of India Limited. These are the three promoters of NSDL. Then the next one is, what are the service or the functions provided by National Securities Depository Limited? NSDL performs various types of functions through the participants. The first one is, it maintains investors holding in electronic form. As it is one of the depository service organization and a depository system means those organization are eligible to provide depository service through online platform or through electronic form that are called as the depository service. So NSDL, as it is the first depository service, it's basic role is to maintain the investors holding in physical, not in physical form, that is in electronic form. The second function, it enables the surrender and withdrawal of securities and from the depository. Whenever any share purchase made by the investor, that service facilities through depository provided by NSDL, and whenever investor wants to sell the share and withdraw the money, in that case also, the service facilities provided by the NSDL. So it enables both surrender facilities as well as a withdrawal of securities and from the depository service or from the depository system. The third function, it affects settlement of securities traded on exchange. Not only it involves depository service facilities, it also involves settlement of securities which are made through stock exchange. Then the fourth function, it carries out settlements that have not been made on the stock exchange. Though the settlement service facilities are not made in stock exchange, that service facility is also provided by NSDL. Then the fifth function, it makes allotment in electronic form of initial public offering. At the time of issuing IPO, whenever company wants to raise funds from the public for the first time, in that case, all types of allotment of IPO is made in electronic form by the NSDL. Then the sixth function, it offers facility for freezing or locking of investors' account. Whenever there is any freezing or there is any locking of investors' account, in that case, that problem is also solved by NSDL. Then the next one is, it facilitates offer of securities as a mortgage for a loan. Any type of a loan, if investor wants, by way of placing their securities, then that type of mortgage facility also provided by the NSDL in the form of offer of securities. Then who are the participants of NSDL? NSDL performs its function through its various participants. The following are some of the important participants of NSDL. One is IIT Trust, second one is Corporation Service, then the next one is Global Trust Bank, HDFC Bank, City Bank Custodial Service, Morgan Stanley Custodial Service, Reliance Share and Stock Broking, Janta Sahakari Bank, Industrial Development Bank of India, State Bank of India, Standard Chartered Bank, National Securities Clearing Corporation of India, then Deutsche Bank. So these are some of the major participants of NSDL. Then what is the legal aspects involved in NSDL? That means the rules and the regulation or the criteria which are issued by Securities Contract Act as well as Companies Act that must have been involved with NSDL. So which are the legal aspects of NSDL? NSDL was established by passing of the Depository Act 1996, but with retrospective effect from 1995, Companies Act and the Securities Contract Regulation Act were amended suitably to facilitate the operation of NSDL. So with effect from September 1995, when there is certain amendments made in Companies Act as well as the Securities Contract Regulation Act, time to time all amendments are suitably made to facilitate the operational activities through NSDL. Section 22A of the Securities Contract Regulation Act deals with the restriction on transfer of shares that was deleted. So in 22A of Depository Act or Section 22A of Indian Securities Contract Regulation Act, there was one rule or policy was made which is basically involves restriction on a transfer of shares, and at the amendment when it was made, that restriction on transfer of a share was deleted. That means Section 22A was permanently deleted. Then section 108 and 111 of Indian Companies Act were also amended, and that was made to dispense with the transfer forms and other formalities relating to physical transfer of a share. There is certain formalities or the procedures made at the time of a physical transfer of a share, and that was mentioned under section 108 and 111 of Indian Companies Act, and that was amended and which made transfer of forms and other formalities relating to more simple. Then the statement issued by the depository are considered valid documents of a title, and on the basis of the depository statements, transfers are effected through book entries in the passbook, and the transaction in demand are not subject to stamp duty. So when the depository service facilities was made by NSDL, in that case there is no transaction cost which was made by which was involved with the stamp duty. Basically, stamp duty was made at the time of a physical transfer of a shares or securities which is made in a scrip based system. But in case electronic form, when the service was made through depository service organization, in that case there was no stamp duty, or a transaction which was made through demat account, that is not subject to any stamp duty. So what is the transaction, or how the transaction is made at NSDL? As we have seen already, the transaction of the stock market are divided into two categories. One is the primary market, second one is the secondary market. Primary market, which is called as a new issue market, secondary market, which was made through stock exchange. So how NSDL service facilities was made both in the primary market as well as in the service market or secondary market. The first one is new issue market. Generally, the investor has the option to receive the shares either in physical form or in electronic mode. That depends upon the investor. If the investor wants to take or has the option to receive the share in physical mode, can be made in physical through share certificate as well as transfer deed. If the investor wants to hold the shares in electronic form, that can also be made through depository service organization. So that is based upon the investor's option. When shares are allotted to the investor, he should specify his choice clearly. So at the time of a share allotment, basically investor made their option very clearly. If he wishes to hold security in electronic form, he should specify to the depository participants to which the allotted shares are to be delivered. So investors, if wishes to hold the share in electronic form, then that must have been made by the investor to the depository participants. Through depository participants, depository organization can hold the shares in electronic form on behalf of the investors. And the shares allotted through primary market in the form of IPO can also be made or to be delivered through electronic form to the particular investor's demat account. Shares will be allotted according to SEBI guidelines. So allotment will be made based upon the guidelines issued by SEBI. But the dispatch of shares to the depository participant will take place according to the investor of or according to the instruction made by the investor. Shares that will be made or that will be transferred based upon the SEBI guideline. But the dispatch of shares to the investors, to the depository participants, will be take place according to the instruction made by the investor. What the mode of instruction or what the option made by the investor, he has to specify it clearly to the depository participants, and accordingly depository participant must have to provide that instruction or information to the depository service, and based upon that everything can be made. But nowadays SEBI has made it compulsory or mandatory to the companies to have a new issue in the dematerialized form. So in present scenario, there is no physical form of a share issue or allotment is made. Whenever allotment is made by the company, those investors to whom the shares are allotted, their shares are compulsorily held in a demat form. In present scenario, there is no physical form of a share allotment. Government has made it mandatory, or SEBI has made it mandatory to all the companies, that when a new issue has been made, it has been made in electronic form to the different investors to whom allotment was made. Then what is the role in secondary market of NSDL? The trading procedure for secondary market transaction are same, but the settlement and the clearing procedure are different. So compared to primary market, the trading process or the procedure in a secondary market is very similar, but there are certain differences relating to settlement and a clearing procedure. It may so happen that the seller opt to deliver the share from the depository while the buyer wishes to take the delivery in physical form and vice versa. So the process is made that when the seller opts to deliver the share from the depository, at that time the buyer wishes to take the delivery in physical form, or that is made in vice versa procedure. That is, the seller has the shares in the physical mode while the buyer prefers in electronic form. That means when sale has been made, it has been made in physical form, but when purchase has been made, the purchase has been made in electronic form. So seller has the option of a physical mode, but buyer has the option of a electronic mode. When both buyer and seller prefers the electronic mode, the transaction would be smooth. So at the time when the both buyer and seller, they have the option of a electronic mode, during that time the transaction would be very smooth and very simple. There will be no problem. Then the next depository service in India is CDSL, that is Central Depository Service of India Limited. So what is this, and when it was established, and what is the basic role provided by CDSL in financial market? Central Depository Service of India Limited. This is the second depository in India. The first depository service, that was NSDL, and the second depository is CDSL. This was formed and registered in 1999. It has 455 depository participants, and that was as per the year, that is 2008, it was prevailed that 455 depository participants are there in a Central Depository Service. Now in India, more than that depository participants, those are taking service through CDSL. The address of a CDSL is at Mumbai, and the website of the CDSL is www.cdslindia.com. Then who are the promoters of a CDSL? One is Bombay Stock Exchange Limited, second one is Bank of India, third one is Bank of Baroda, then SBI, State Bank of India, and another one is HDFC Bank. These are the main promoters of CDSL. Who are the shareholders of CDSL? Standard Chartered Bank, Centurion Bank of Punjab Limited, Canada Bank, Union Bank of India, Bank of Maharashtra, Jammu and Kashmir Bank Limited, the Calcutta Stock Exchange Association Limited, and others who are the major shareholders of CDSL. What is the benefits of a depository system in a dematerialized form? Depository system provides various benefits both to the investors as well as to the issuers. First, we are going to discuss what is the benefits provided by the depository system to the investors. The first one is, the transaction in electronic mode eliminated the risks and the problems of a delays. So when depository service facilities is made through depository system, there is less chance of a risks and also problem. No problem will also arise. So the transaction made in electronic form eliminate all type of risks associated and any type of a problem of a delay. The second benefit is, the risks of a bad delivery is totally or completely ignored or eliminated. Then the third one is, there is no requisite to fill off the transfer deeds and payment of a transfer of a stamp duty and a lot of other paperwork at the end of the investor. So that was made in a script based system. The paperwork is there, the cost involvement is also made higher, and the stamp duty also made by the or borne by the investor. But in case of a depository system, there is no such type of a cost involvement as well as a paperwork. Everything is reduced. Then next benefit, it totally eliminates the risks associated with the fraudulent interception of certificates in postage or in transit. So there is no mutilation, there is no chance of a fraudulent practice involved in a depository system. As it is completely involved with electronic form, there is no chance of a default or there is no chance of a duplicate activities. Any type of fraudulent activities is completely ignored or eliminated through depository system. Then the transfer of a securities or ownership of a securities is immediate in case of a depository mode. So when investor wants to transfer the transfer of a securities can be made at very convenient and as quickly as possible, which is not in a script based system where everything is made through manual process. Then the next benefit to the investor is the investment automatically becomes more liquid. That means whenever we want to purchase, we can purchase it. Whenever we want to sell, we can sell it. And everything, the settlement is can be made as quickly as possible. That's why the system becomes more liquid. Then what is the benefits provided to the issuer or to the issuing company? The first one is the company saves a lot of paperwork. So in a depository system, there is no paperwork. The paperwork is completely reduced or there is less paperwork. So company saves lot of paperwork which is otherwise required in a physical mode. In case of a physical mode, the paperwork was there. But in electronic form, there is no paperwork. The second one is the company saves a postal cost. The postal charges is also reduced. There is no required of a postal cost as it is made in electronic form. And immediately the share certificate through electronically transferred to the investor's mail ID. And the dispatch of a right shares, bonus share or share certificate after affecting the transfer. So when company is made this type of a process, that is a case of a right share or a case of a bonus share or the share certificate, everything has been made as quickly as possible. Then the next benefit, by offering depository services to the shareholders, company may send a positive sign to the shareholder about its concerns for their welfare. So the company at the time of providing depository service to the shareholders make a positive sign or send a positive sign to all the shareholders about its concern for their welfare. Then the next benefit, depository service adds liquid to the security that funds raising capacity of the company. So when it provides liquid facility, that implies raising capacity for the company. What is the role and advantages of CDSL? One is wide DP network. CDSL has more number of depository participants and that spread about number of countries at a present more than 114 cities or towns across the country providing all type of depository service facility through CDSL to the investors and to select a depository participant based on his location. Then the second one is online DP service. So everything is made through online and DP service is also made through online. The branches of a DP can also be directly connected to CDSL, thereby providing online and efficiently depository service to the investors. Then the third benefit, wide spectrum of securities also available for demat. That means an investor can hold almost all securities in one account with CDSL, such as bond, debenture, commercial paper, any type of government securities and a certificate of a deposit. Whenever any type of securities are made by the investor or an investor wants to make any type of security transaction, maybe that relates to debenture, maybe relates to bond or certificate of deposit or commercial paper, whatever may be, everything can be held or made available through one demat account of the investor. That's why it is called as a wide spectrum of a service available for demat. CDSL has kept its tariff very competitive to provide affordable depository service to investor. So at a very low cost, CDSL now providing all type of service facilities to the investors and that is made throughout the country. Number of depository participants and in almost more number of countries in India or in our country, CDSL provides all type of depository service both in cities as well as in major towns. Then the next benefit, that is CDSL system is based on a centralized data architecture, database architecture. That means one major central hub is there, that is at a head office at Mumbai and everything done through that central hub. DPs can thus provide online depository service with to the minute status of the investor's accounts. The entire database of investor is centrally located at a CDSL. If there is any system related issues at a DP's end, the investor is not affected as entire data is available at a CDSL. That signifies that if any type of a problem will arise in one location, in that case, investors are not affected because everything is controlled and operated through central hub of CDSL. So the database system is controlled and operated by the CDSL system, which is located at a head office Mumbai. And whenever any problem will arise or one particular location it is affected, that means not signifies that investors are affected. The investors, they are safe, as the database system is controlled and operated by the CDSL at a central hub, Mumbai. So these are the basic service of the two depository service organization, that is NSDL and CDSL, the basic roles, service facilities and the merit points that we have discussed in our today's class. In our next class, we will discuss the other parts relating to that depository service. So hope you students have cleared about our today's class. Have a good day to all of you.